How's it going and welcome to the episode number 7 of the Arsenal career mode over on FIFA 21. This career mode is taking a shape because now we're nearly into the January transfer window. We're gonna play Everton on the 30th and then we are into the January transfer window. And to be fair, I am looking to make some signings because we've got a good 20 odd million left because I didn't left this money for January, and there are some areas that I would like to improve in the squad that we've got currently, and there are some players that I want to sell as well, so we could get a bit of extra cash. So for me, I think we'll be looking at around 40 million to spend this winter to give us that extra boost which we need. And yeah, that's that. And one more announcement: Bukayo Saka wins the player of the episode. He's got an outrageous goal. And yeah, he's very talented. He's a talented youngster. And yeah, amazing. But one problem is there with Saka, that he has a 70 million release clause, which we're not letting it activate because we don't want a release clause on Bukayo Saka. Because if Saka leaves us, well, he's not happy with his contract also. So I don't want Bukayo Saka to leave at any point. I want him to stay at Arsenal for entirety of his career in real life, and in this for at least two or three seasons what we're doing. So his demands aren't that much. That's a very low demand, to be fair. 42.5 for Bukayo Saka is an absolute bargain. So we've removed the release clause we had on him. So that's that. So yeah, if you enjoyed the video, drop a like, subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss out on any of my latest contents. And yeah, let's begin with the video. So guys, as I told you earlier, we have a good 23 odd million left with us. And these are the three players I'm targeting. I want to sign either Jonathan David or Donny Mullen, because I feel like, you know, if we can sign one of them, they could probably a star striker next term. Because they've got great potential. And Emi Buendia, because we need a backup for Nicola Pepe. So that's that. And I'm also looking to sell Willian. I'm just not impressed by him. Is we can get that wage bill also. Pablo Mari's on very high wages. Runarsson, just get them moving. Cedric is also someone I want to sell. And loan deals are going through. And the thing with Nketiah is that he's suffering from injury. So we need a striker. And I'm looking at strikers whom, if we can get now, then we can, like this term, they can just get into the team. And next season, they can take the striker's spot. Because Lacazette and Aubameyang, whatever you say, are aging. So the first game of the episode is going to be Everton. And now here comes the situation now. We probably have to play Martinelli up top because of course, Eddie Nketiah's injury. So, Martinelli is gonna play up top. Also, Danny Ceballos is... Where is Danny Ceballos, to be fair? Well, I think... Yeah, here he is. Danny Ceballos is gonna play this game. For the first time, I think he's playing. So, yeah, best of luck to Danny Ceballos. He's playing. And yeah, apart from that, I'm gonna keep a similar sort of a team. I think we'll play Rob Holding at centre back. So that's that. So this is my team for Everton. So hopefully we can get the dub. Let's go. Here we are then, guys, against Everton at Goodison Park. It's a big game for us. It's a game that we need to win if we want to keep our European hopes alive. We haven't been in the best of form. We don't have a captain starting today, Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang. And because of that, Martinelli gets a start. And yeah, Everton, they're a good team, Everton. We've got decent defense, well organized under the Carlo Ancelotti. That's what you expect from, I think, Italian management. But here's Martinelli. He's seen Lacazette, and space has opened up for Alex Lacazette. He's gonna go in and across, and oh, it's kept in by Lacazette's head. It should have gone out for a corner, and instead it's kept in. Because I don't wanna see the chicken celebration. He just scored there, but I don't wanna see Richarlison score because I don't wanna see the chicken celebration, and I don't wanna let Iwobi score because he's a former Arsenal player. But yeah, so don't want players that you sold to score against you, do you? And Hussemawa nearly fell for Iowa. Anyway, I think he was offside here, Hussemawa. And now in for Iowa again. He can now see Bukayo Saka, who can put in a delivery for Gabriel Martinelli. That was a good run from Gabby. He's playing as a centre forward today. And yeah, I think he's a third choice striker currently with an Nketiah's injury. But we are looking to sign a striker. That's a ball. No, that's why we sold Iwobi. That's why we actually sold him. Because he's... Oh no, Richarlison, no. Oh my god, Richarlison. Just what you don't want to see. Like, oh my. Then just skip this. I can't see. And Iwobi doing the chicken as well. Iwobi, you're a snake. You are an absolute snake, Alex Iwobi. Came from the Arsenal Academy and he's doing the chicken celebration. Shame on you, Iwobi. I don't think you'll do that in real life, but whatever it is. And Martinelli, or Martin, like a comeback thing since we probably bet Liverpool in, I think, September, was it? And that's going to be half time at Goodison Park. And we are absolutely struggling here. We need to get things right this half. We need to get things right. And just for that, Danny Ceballos has been absolutely nowhere to be found. Martin Odegaard is going to play. And he's been brought in. Hopefully, Odegaard can help change the game. I say hopefully. We need to change the game here. And yeah, hopefully we can do it. Iowa is now going to be a big run here. Iwobi and Saka nearly got it off. Iwobi there, Bukayo Saka. And now Montiel, he's got speed, but not enough to beat Iowa. And Montiel again. And Kieran Tierney, that's an early ball in. That's amazing football. That's just amazing football from Everton that you can't do anything about it. You just can't do anything about it. We are in turmoil. We're in absolute turmoil. We're missing Aubameyang. We're missing our big guns. And we're in turmoil currently. We're in turmoil. And we have to make this. We can't go 3-1 down. We can't go 3-0 down. We have to do something here. We have to do something. Here's Odegaard. Now, Nico Pepe. Now, this is it now. Pepe. And he's put it in for Lacazette. Lacazette, Pickford is on something today. Pickford is legitimately on something today. He's stopping everything like it's easy. Lacazette must have had 3 or 4 shots on him. And he's done nothing. Like, this is outrageous this now. And we have to go for it now. Emil Smith-Rowe is the guy who's gonna come in. So Odegaard and Smith-Rowe both on the pitch. Aubameyang on the pitch as well. So it's like we're throwing the kitchen sink at it now, basically. We're trying to do what we are. Our back four is gonna be exposed a bit on Ancelotti's high press, but something has gotta give. So Saka now. He's seen Aubameyang in space. Pierre-Emerick, what is that, Aubameyang? What is that? I was hoping that Kieran Tierney made the run, but he never did. And that is what has cost us. And Everton now, just don't play dirty Everton. That's what I don't want to see. We're probably going to get sacked at this rate. We have got to make signings. That shows that. Because... And Iwobi is in. Oh my god. We are getting thrashed here. Alex Iwobi. I didn't even see whether he scored or not. Because I didn't wanna. What is that? What even is actually give up? I decide to give up now. This is outrageous. I don't wanna see. How are we gonna get European football? At this rate, we're gonna lose to Augsburg in the Europa League. How are we gonna get European football? I'll never know. 3-0. This is humiliating, guys. I don't know what's about. Just get this done. Recalled by Real Madrid. That's something I'm not looking at. But we've got a Cedric transfer offer for 6 million now. Yeah, his value is that. We'll take that. 29-year-old, 76 rated only. I don't think that's good. So Balogun has left on loan and Nelson has also left on loan. So that's good news for us. And now we've got a game against Accrington. Accrington, I don't know what this sort of club is. I'm just gonna like bomb through this. FA Cup, probably a chance of a trophy. But come on, eh? Accrington we're playing. Not gonna play this team. Well, what's my number two team? This is my number two team. Yeah, let's play with this. So, Accrington Town. Yeah, 3-0. Easy dub. Martinelli brace. And Lacazette scores as well. So, yeah, a disappointment all around currently. But we've got few Premier League games to turn this around here. We've got a few Premier League games to turn around. Next one is going to be Southampton, which I'm probably going to be simming. So, yeah, because last episode we also played Southampton. And now we're also playing them. We should be able to beat Southampton pretty easily in my eyes. Because we absolutely thrashed them last time around. And Willian wants to play. Well, Willian is going to leave the club soon. So, Cedric has been sold. Lacazette transfer off. I'm not going to entertain that. We've got around 30 mil now. Southampton, they're 17th in the league. They're struggling. My number one team versus Southampton. We should get the dub easily. Come on. And we do get the dub 3-2. It's a Bakayo Saka brace. Partey scores as well. So we get back to winning ways. Leicester and Chelsea draw. They drop points. And now we're going to play Leicester in our next game. And if we beat Leicester, who knows? Who knows? If we beat Leicester, well, we're not even near them in goal differential terms. But if we beat Leicester, we'll be level on points with Leicester. And then top 4 looks out of reach. But at least top 4, top 5, top 6. So, yeah, let's get started now. Leicester game up and coming. This game, we got around 31 million with us. And I'm going to go in for Donny Malin. He's 80 rated, 21 year old at Barcelona. So, we should be offering around 36 million. But I have an idea by which we can sign Donny Malin. If we fail this, Jonathan David is of course the one we're gonna sign. But I have an idea, and what I'm gonna do is not offer Saka or Pepe or Martinelli. I'm gonna offer Willian as much as ridiculous as this sounds. Willian plus 29 million for Donny Malin. They want a straight swap for Iowa for Malin. Are they mad? We're gonna give them 30 million. Plus, can't we give Willian again? No, we can't give Willian again. So, I don't have any options left then. Center backs. Yeah, we'll do Pablo Mari plus 30 million. Oh my god. Actually, Barcelona have accepted Pablo Mari. Pablo Mari is going to Barca. Oh my days. Oh my days, Donny Malin. Now I'm gonna give him important squad role. Probably rotation is what we have. But actually, we've signed Donny Malin. He's got great potential. And next season, I tell you, next season, Malin will be a god signing for us. We'll give him what he's earning at Barca. We'll give him a million signing bonus. And that's reasonable. And he's in. I expected to bring in David, not Malin. But we've got Donny Malin. And it's an absolute amazing thing that we've got him. We're of course gonna be selling Willian. But Donny Malin is in. And yeah, it's outrageous how we've bought him in. And we're gonna play Leicester now this epi. And it's gonna be the last game of the epi, to be fair. Because I'm not gonna play Chelsea in this episode, and it's gonna be Donny Malin's debut. He's got 91 pace, and it's gonna be his debut versus Leicester. Hopefully we can turn it around, and I'm gonna be playing the two striker formation, Donny Malin and Aubameyang, pace up top, go catch Leicester. Donny Malin's debut for Arsenal. Let's go. Now gonna be playing his debut match for Arsenal here. This is big here. Next season is probably going to be our main centre forward. I expected to sign Jonathan David. Donny Malin wasn't in my thinking process, but I said, why not just try and go for him, because he's better than David in terms of potential and current rating. And we've got him, so that's a very good business, you have to say. And Barca want Pablo Mari. That's, I guess, typical Barcelona. If you tell this to Barca fans, you'd say Bartomeu would make that transfer. So, yeah, that's been made. And now Pau Torres has a lot of open space. Here's Bukayo Saka. He does the step overs well. Here's Aubameyang. Oh, that's a great save. Kasper Schmeichel there. So, Aubameyang beginning well here. Now, a front post delivery for Aubameyang. And Schmeichel chooses not to catch, but to punch. Don't know why. And, I mean, we drew it less the last episode. Because, well, in FIFA, December, January, the games almost remain the same. And Jose Mawa now. Now, Jose Mawa in for Donny Malin on his debut. And he's seen the open space for Nicolas Pepe. Donny Malin. Nico Pepe scores. Donny Malin gets an assist on his debut. Saw the space for Pepe. Played it to him. And good to see Malin bond and get an assist in his first game. Nicolas Pepe bringing it on to his left foot. It just seems like Pepe enjoys playing Leicester away, doesn't he? In real life, that scorcher of a win. James Maddison here. I don't know why Emerson afforded that much space. And here's Gabriel Jesus. Oh, what a save, Leno. And on the rebound, Gabriel Jesus scores. We are absolute bottlers, guys. Our defensive skills are atrocious. Because Gabriel is slow. Pau Torres can't save us always. He saves us 7 out of 10 times. Can't save us always. But yeah, I think this is... Oh, we worked so hard to get into a lead at Leicester. We need to win this game to cut the gap down at Chelsea, to cut the gap down at Leicester. We need to win this game at all costs. And we've played well, but Leicester have dominated the ball. They haven't let us have the ball. They're playing so well now, Leicester. Look at this. This is atrocious. And Kieran Tierney finally makes a challenge. But they're doing little flicks and clicks and everything. This is atrocious here. And now... Emerson trying to play it into Pepe, never really worked. Look at this, they are playing like they are playing in a playground and we are allowing it. And you know, we just ain't got the players. I do feel that we're a better team than what we were when I came in terms of basically the ability, but I don't think we've played well. It dismantled us, so that's not what we want here. Get an opportunity, we should be able to take it. And it's in for... Oh, come on, Pau Torres, do something. No. Oh, what a mistake. What a mistake. No, Emerson. Emerson has messed up. Emerson has messed up and Ndidi has scored. I don't understand this. If we lose to Leicester, it's actually game done. It's actually done if we lose to Leicester here. Here's Pepe now. Now we have to play with urgency now. We have to play with some sort of an urgency. We have to play with some sort of something like... Currently, it's bang average here. Leicester are dominating us. We can't get anything off. And we're struggling. Where's my defense? I'm playing on balance. I'm not even playing on attacking. And the defense is non-existent. My defense is absolutely non-existent. Look at this. I'm actually speechless. I am actually speechless here. Defense is non-existent. There's nothing in the defense there. We just... Lacazette, look at Schmeichel again. Look at Kasper Schmeichel. He is... How is he doing this? And why only to us? Why only to us? Gabriel now. Pepe, get a goal, Nico. Pepe, don't celebrate. We lose in 3-2. I think the formational change is what we need, I think. We need a formational change. We've lost 3-2 to Leicester again. This is not good. We're struggling. We can't even get a European place at this point. Pepe with a 10-on-10. I don't know how. We've lost the game and he's got a 10-on-10. You're joking me. But forgetting all of that, we're currently sitting 9th in the Premier League. Now 5 points off. We're struggling. And I think we need a formational change. We do need a formational change. So guys, that's it for me for now. If you enjoyed the video, drop a like, subscribe to the channel. If you want to, you can please send in suggestions of what formational change can I do. So yeah, till then, enjoy and yeah, see you later.